But right now, I want to move quickly to introduce to you a young man that I met many, many years ago. He's the pastor of Prayer and Faith Outreach Ministries. At the age of 8, he was impressed, God impressed upon William to gather some of his friends together and begin a church at 8 years old, huh? Now, wait a minute. At the age of 11, he was licensed, and at 12, he was ordained to preach the gospel by his pastor, Reverend F.D. Johnson. Put your hands together for Pastor William Hudson III. Hey, William, God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
God bless you. It is wonderful to see you and to see how God has so richly blessed your ministry.
God be the glory.
Why don't you tell the folk how we met? And I didn't realize how long ago it was.
Well, at the age of 3, the Spirit of the Lord began to move in me, and I began to preach. I couldn't read at 3, but my sister had a picture Bible. I would look at the pictures, and she told me the Bible stories. I would preach from the pictures. My father is not in ministry. Actually, he got saved and filled with the Holy Spirit under my ministry.
Praise the Lord.
God is just an awesome God.
Yeah.
It was absolutely nothing I had anything to do with, just the Spirit of the Lord moving in my life. I got filled with the Holy Ghost at the age of 4, and my scripture was Mark 16, that in my name they shall lay hands on the sick, they shall cast out devils. So I started laying hands on the sick, casting out devils, making sure that God's people were set free. The Lord really has given me the ministry of healing and deliverance.
Praise
my favorite
God.
Scripture is Psalms 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Mm. And my assignment in the body is to let the body of Christ know that if you have Jesus, you are healed, you are delivered, and you are indestructible.
Praise
There's
God.
Nothing the enemy can do to stop you. And at 13 years old, actually, I met this great Reverend Clifton Davis as we played on the Amen show. I was Reverend Johnny, and of course, you were the star, and I just can't believe that was over 30 years ago.
My
You're getting
Lord.
Old, Rev. You're Woo! Getting old.
Wow. My. That was almost 30 years ago. Let's not push it too far, man. But the truth of the matter is we had a wonderful broadcast there where people were, Reverend Johnny was a great preacher, and everybody said Reverend Johnny was going to take Reverend Reuben Gregory's church away from him. And I said, well, he's just a lovely young man. And then we had this preaching competition.
Yes.
And I got to tell you, this young man preached, do you hear me?
Well.
He made me work hard. I had to, whoa, I was shouting up in there. It was one of the funniest shows where these two preachers were competing. And this was a 13-year-old young man at the time. And look what God hath done.
Thank you, Jesus.
And now, you've been pastoring the church that you started for how long now?
Well, it's been about 30 years.
My
I started
Lord.
At 8 years old.
Wow.
And I still have some members, my founding members who started with me, who are still there with me now.
Praise
and
the
it's
Lord.
It's amazing. The way the Lord blessed me to do it is by having good leadership.
Mm-hmm.
My pastor, Bishop Roy Brown, mm-hmm. Trained me, mentored me, and taught me.
Mm-hmm.
I started counseling married couples at 13 years old. I
wow.
did my first wedding at 12. I just got ordained at my first wedding, and I'm counseling couples. Of course, I had no experience, but through the Word of God and through my mentor, the Holy Spirit led me and got me. The Holy Spirit is a teacher,
mm-hmm.
and there's some things you learn from reading, but there's some things the Holy Spirit teaches you mm-hmm. from within.
Yes.
So it is the wisdom and the knowledge of God, and I'm just so excited that I'm still here.
Hey, praise God.
God is amazing. This July 2010, my Bishop Roy Brown consecrated me into the bishopric, and so I have about 25 churches that are under me, and it's a new experience. I'm just excited about what God is doing.
Well, Bishop, it's a pleasure to see how God has just developed you and moved in your life and enriched what the call that was on your life so young
Praise God.
Has been fulfilled.
Praise God.
It's a wonderful thing. Well, talk to us a little bit about I saw this, and we've got a picture of this. I want to show you this. It says, don't die in the wilderness. There it is. This is you ministering on 1 Kings 19, 1 through 8. Would you share a little bit of what this one is about, this message?
Well, by being in ministry so long, I realized that there's so many people who are praise and worship leaders in the church, mm-hmm. who are prayer warriors, who are pastors, but secretly, they're depressed. They're discouraged. They're going through so many things. And just because people are in church lifting their hands and praising God, it does not mean that everything is okay in their life. Mm. And the Lord gave me this. He said, don't die in the wilderness, because Elijah was a mighty man of God. He was a prophet of God. This man prayed and God sent fire down from heaven. Yes. In 1 Kings 18, he prayed a 63-word prayer. And with 63 words, God sent fire down from heaven. God broke the laws of nature. We all know fire does not burn down. Fire burns up. That's but 63 words changed the laws of nature, man. Fire burned down. Wow. He had water there on the altar. And 63 words, water puts fire out. But 63 words with God, fire, amen, burned up the water. Wow. God is an awesome God.
Yes, he
this
is.
This man prayed and God shut the heavens. And no rain came for 3 years and 6 months. Mm. He prayed again and God opened up the heavens and sent the rain. But yet after all of this, after these great victories, he went through a storm. He went through a battle. He's in the wilderness running from Jezebel, a woman. Lord, have mercy, a woman. He's in the wilderness sitting under a juniper tree saying, Lord, I give up. I can't take it anymore. I want to die. Just kill me. It's over. And I'm charging God's people. There's a pastor that's watching right now. Mm-hmm. And I want to say to you, don't you die in the wilderness. Mm-hmm. What you're going through is only a temporary situation. Mm-hmm. And I realize that whatever wilderness you're going through, this is the place that God's getting ready to bless you. Mm-hmm. If it's a financial wilderness, he's getting ready to give you more money than you ever had before.
Praise
if it's
the
a
Lord.
Family wilderness, God's getting ready to increase and bless your family. Mm-hmm. If it's a wilderness in your body, God's getting ready to heal you and make you whole. Mm-hmm. See, wherever the enemy attacks, that's the place that God has targeted a blessing. Mm-hmm. And so God is getting ready to catapult Elijah to another level in his ministry, mm-hmm. because the wilderness is a place of transition. It's a place of change. Mm-hmm. He was burned out. He was burned out. He had blackout. He lost his vision. Mm-hmm. He lost his purpose. He felt alone and lonely, like nobody understood and nobody was there. But while he was there complaining, saying, Lord, I can't take no more. I give up. Divine intervention took place. Mm-hmm. God sent an angel. And I want to tell somebody that's watching, you may be depressed and discouraged, but you've got a purpose and God has a plan for your life. And God's getting ready to interrupt your wilderness situation.
All
right. I see the angels of the Lord interrupting that season of depression and letting you know that you're shifting into the greatest season of your life. Elijah was there. God interrupted his depression and the angel came with a word from the Lord. Mm. He's trying to die and give up. The angel said, you gotta eat and you gotta drink. That's what we need in the wilderness.
Yes.
We gotta eat the bread of God, mm-hmm. the word of God. Let it get down in your spirit.
That's right.
And that water represents the Holy Spirit. Mm. He was revived. He was renewed as the Spirit of God moved on him. Mm. You know, we all have wilderness in. And in the wilderness, God takes your prayer life to another level.
Yes.
Man, when you're going through, you pray like never before.
That's true.
You know, you intercede. The word intercede actually means to interrupt, to block, and to stop. Mm-hmm. So when God begins to stir your prayer life in the wilderness, he begins to block every attack of the enemy.
Oh,
he begins
God.
To stop. He sent cancer, but you blocked it through intercession.
Mm.
He sent that spirit of heaviness, but you blocked it through intercession. And so God took him to another level, mm-hmm. through prayer and then praise.
Mm.
Because when you praise God, the Bible says that Judah would have his hand. Of course, Judah means praise. Mm-hmm. Judah would have his hand in the neck of his enemy. Mm-hmm. When you begin to praise God, when you're going through, when you're in a trial, when you're in a storm, and you lift your hands and say, Lord, I love you. Lord, I praise you. While you're praising, the Lord is positioning your hand in the neck of your enemy.
Come on.
He won't put it on the enemy's head because his hands are loose. His feet are loose.
Mm-hmm.
He won't put your hands on the enemy's feet because his head is loose.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get that enemy by the neck, you paralyze him from the top to the bottom, and he can't do anything else. That's what praise will do. Uh-huh. So don't die in the wilderness.
Yeah.
He sat under a juniper tree. Mm. You got to get up and praise God and pray, and God's going to turn it around and take you into your next assignment. When he came out, he anointed three more kings.
Yes.
And that was his purpose. So praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm living.
Yeah.
Can't stop.